Colton's my 21-year-old son. He is a second-year student at CalU University. He also joined the Pennsylvania Army National Guard and is in the military police company. And he's also deployed to Kuwait right now. When I found out Colton was going to be deployed, I right away felt very anxious and very sad. I was overwhelmed. I believe the family is, you know, it's hit the family pretty hard. We're a real close family. Colton has three other siblings, and everyone misses him terribly. It's just so different. Colton and his brother Tanner are very close, and I feel like that has a special bond in itself. Colton and his older sister Shauna, you know, they have that bond as being the two older children. And then Colton has a sister Morgan who is the youngest, and she pals around with him quite a bit. Colton's been on deployment for 5 months now. He left in August of 2018, and it is currently now February, so he's been gone 5 months, and he will be back sometime this summer. So we're looking between 9 and 12 months of a deployment. Colton being gone, the family, it's obviously we're missing someone. The holidays were really hard. Just knowing that he was not here to celebrate with us. His birthday's coming up, and that'll be another hard day. We just miss his presence around the house, missing coming home from college and stopping in for dinner, or stopping in, of course, to have his laundry done by mom. We miss him in the evenings. We miss sitting around watching movies together. Knowing that my son would be gone for at 9 to 12 months, not being part of the family, missing all the holidays and vacations and everything that we do as a family. But yeah, overall anxious, somewhat sad, nervous for him. Tried to be excited for him, although it was very hard as a mom to be excited when you know your son's going to be out of the country in a military setting for the better part of a year. I miss the phone calls and the texting. It's just been hard with very little communication when he's over in Kuwait being deployed. Christmas without Colton here was really hard. It just felt like a piece was missing. We had his gifts under the tree, although we knew he wouldn't be home to open them. It was very hard shopping, knowing that I wouldn't be buying the things for him like I normally would be because he isn't here. New Year's again was hard, you know, although I think Christmas was worse. Christmas is more of a family time when we all are home together for several days at a time. New Year's was hard, although we did get to FaceTime Colton over the holidays, which made it a little bit easier, but it was still not the same as having him here at home. As a mom, when one of your children are deployed, you lose all sense of control over your child. You cannot provide him with food, warmth, can't help him if they're, you know, feeling sick. You lose total control as a parent over his whole life. There's nothing I can do for him. I can't help him in any way if he needs something. I can't, like I said, provide meals for him, or I can't do his laundry, all the things that a mom would normally do for their child. Sometimes when we do try to FaceTime him, it's he's busy, or it's just the wrong time of the day with it being an 8-hour time difference in Kuwait. It just doesn't always make it possible to talk to him. So as a mom, you just kind of feel like you've been put on the back burner. So I think it's affected everyone. I feel like as his mom, I feel like it's probably hit me the hardest, just not having one of my children here at home. No, I'd probably cry. But I would, if once I see Colton when he gets home here, I will probably give him a big hug and probably cry, just because it's been so long since he's been home with the family. Tell him I miss him and let him know that, you know, even though he was gone for a year, almost a year, that, you know, things here are, we missed him and things here are still the same, and we want him to come back home and basically just jump right back into home life like he would have as if he was never gone. I am very proud of Colton for choosing his career as military police. Like I said, he's a second year student at CalU University, and I am very proud of him. I feel like he's endured a lot in the military thus far. While I am very proud of him, I don't know that I would be able to withstand some of the things that he's endured, but I am proud that he has chosen a path that not only serves our country, but makes his career, gives his career a boost and will help him in his, future life. When Colton comes home this summer, of course, it'll be a big homecoming, and I plan to have lots of his favorite foods prepared for him when he gets here, and some of the things I know he hasn't had since he's left. I don't know, I'd just like to, once he gets home, I'd like to just sit down and just enjoy some family time here at home with him. Again, maybe watching movies or hanging out at, at our swimming pool. Would like to take an RV trip, take a family vacation, and just be able to spend time with him and hear all about the things that he did over in Kuwait, the things that he saw, the things that he's learned while he was over there. And we do have a lot of catching up to do with things that has happened here at home that we just don't have time to tell him about. When Colton comes home, I think everyone's gonna be just overjoyed. Everyone's missed him a lot this year, and I believe that there will be a lot of tears, there'll be a lot of hugs. If Colton had an opportunity to see this video, I would just want him to know that we all love him and we all miss him. We're all very proud of him. We can't wait till he gets home. And, I hope that he doesn't have to ever go away this long again. This has been already been a long deployment, and we still have a few months to go, but he'll get through it, we'll get through it, and he'll be home before we know it.